There'll be more than waves crashing at this location. This is the Summer of Fighters.
PS1 game that uses numpad notation? What?
Yeah, it's Mo. Mo did a bang up job. He literally bought the game.
Oh, it is Lord. Oh, it's Lord Mora. You're right.
Yeah, our Mo. He literally bought the game's official fucking strategy guide and he put it up on there.
Funny.
He technically helped out tonight. Because this is my choice. This
Lord Mo is a big veteran of the FGC.
Yeah, he's one of the founders.
I know who Lord Mo is.
But do you know that it's time for Summer of Fighters? Yeah. You see what I did there? You
sure
like that?
Is.
All right, welcome back to Summer of Fighters, folks. The Eric Picks train keeps on a rolling with verses on PS1. We got Robo, we got Frosty, we got Miles. And as I said, this is my choice right here.
I thought the game was called Game Versus Option.
Lol. But anyways, there's a bit of a story as to why I chose this of all things. And I know there's a story that Frosty would like to tell, but let's get mine first. I chose this game because, as we all know, at a time, I once fancied myself as a fighting game reviewer. Put out a few videos. They were all right. Honestly, I kind of want to redo the first one and maybe the second one. But I bought a few games that I was planning on using as fodder for the show. I bought Battle Arena Toshiden 1, I bought Rise of the Robots 2, and I bought this on a whim. I don't think there was much on this game at the time because, well, you know, with a name like Versus, it's very easy to look up online, I'm sure. So I figured if I'm ever going to actually review this thing, we might as well play it for Summer of Fighters. So, Frosty, you want to also explain the additional backstory about this game here?
So, in the arcades and in Japan on PS1, there is no Versus. There is Fighters Impact, which has significantly better character design, character select, and just better characters in general.
So what we got here is a quasi reskin slash remake of a totally different fighting game meant to appeal to us Westerners.
Now, does it have a state where it says you win !? Because Fighters Impact has that.
No, I don't think it does. Sounds like it should though. But anyways, who wants to go up first?
I feel like I'm going to suck because it's been forever since I've played Versus.
Oh, don't worry. I barely played this for years now. Trust me.
It's been a while since I've played Fighters Impact also. But at the same time, I feel like since I connected first, I may as well go for it.
Are you guys cool with that?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, let's Versus.
Then also, I need some time to translate the freaking notation because I'm kind of stupid when it comes to the Tekken number notation.
Just look at your keypad numbers. You'll remember it that way. Anyways, this versus the select screen. Basically, we got three gangs. We got the hood. We got streets. We got beach. We got campus. And you just press up, and it's not a very good select screen.
This is one of the worst select screens I've ever used.
I get what they're going for, but it's so weird.
I'm going to be the guy named after a non-alcoholic beer.
I'm going to go as Slick, a pimp named Slip Daddy.
You know, one letter away from that other guy, you need to get yourself take it to a the JoJo streets. Character.
Also, I should mention, this game has ska in it, so get ready.
Well, I suppose that's a redeeming factor.
Here we go!
Excuse me.
Although movement is weird because you don't walk, you just dash automatically.
And what's this going on with? Oh, that's something. So you only have two attack buttons then.
Two attacks. I think you got a dedicated block and an evade.
Yeah, it seems there's a dedicated. Yeah, and then. Man, this is weird.
Oh, so it's basically Virtua Fighter 3.
Well, it feels like it's like, what, 5 buttons? Because the block button is on the trigger.
Huh.
Is it? No, I realize it. Oh, there you go.
I punched you in the gut, and I guess that was enough.
Luckily, I only drink non-alcoholic beer, so I'll be fine.
Pretty decent models for the PS1.
Crap.
I do have to say, even though I'm not a huge fan of these character designs,
the models look nice.
They do have. There are many things nice about them. Like, yes, the general models and the textures. The textures are decent, actually.
I think they look pretty nice. Actually, they look a lot nicer than the official art on their character select portraits.
Ooh, juggles!
Character select portraits are terrible.
Who's who?
I'm Slim Daddy, and Frosty is the light beer guy.
I'm O'Doul. The easy way to remember is that he drinks non-alcoholic beer.
So does that mean you're related to N'Doul? Damn it.
Damn, you stole my joke that I freaking fumbled earlier.
Oh wow, you gotta kick me, son.
And the K is backwards.
That's beautiful. Funny. I'm really glad that exists now. Suddenly, I appreciate this character a lot more.
Okay, let me just fix the audio really quick.
All right.
Here we go. All right, that's one for Frosty. See, who do we got in the hood? We got Ramos. We got Jaleel. Thana.
Not normal.
Paco.
What else do we got?
Go of Jaleel, whose style is Taekwondo, apparently, and he's a recycler.
We got Paco, we got Thana, we got a genetic freak who's not normal.
What?
Wait, why am I only allowed to pick hood? Oh, there we go. Alright, maybe I'll be the blind guy this time. Or but actually, what are the other girls, what do the other people do? Leith, you know what? I'll be Leith, because I don't know why, just...
Let's take it to the construction site.
That name really strikes out to me for some reason.
I appreciate them adding a little mini game to this as well.
Yeah, thank God, Captain.
This must have been before Namco trademarked it or patented it. Sorry.
Oh, they actually show the title of the song that they got. That's actually really nice.
Yeah,
that's...
but it's not a ska song, so I don't like this one. I need those trumpets, dog.
Not a lot of games did that until much later on in the industry.
The thing is, I'm not even sure if they're like actual licensed songs or they're from like a random indie band they found. Like with Virtuoso on 3DO, if anyone knows that.
Oh my god, yeah, I do.
I remember watching a review of that game and thinking the music was like, the music is very C tier grunge because it was the late 90s or whatever. And it's like, I'm a bundle of nerves, I'll tell you to take it. Miles, you can vouch for me on this, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, just look at the main character of that game.
He looks like Dog the Bounty Hunter.
He does.
Like a solid extra 5 pounds on. Alright, that's one for each of us.
Does the game just do a rematch if you click retry?
Yeah.
So you have to keep going back just to change characters?
This was before we figured out quick select.
Alright, I'm gonna be the blind exchange student.
So we've got Kenny, he's a pro wrestler. We got Kalukag, who's Free Kai. A mime. Wait, I don't want to choose a mime. Fuck mimes. And Kara.
That's not a mime. That's the fucking Joker.
Yeah, it's Gangweed. See, oh, okay. We do got different stages. I was about to wonder. Venice Beach looks like it might have some ska. I really love ska, guys. Did you know that?
You're so subtle about it. I can barely tell.
You know the Twitter account make up a fighting game player.
Oh yeah, this is ska. Listen, baby.
Oh my god, it is.
Wow, just
yeah. Now we're playing the Tough Breaker game.
Wow, just like the original version of Fighter's Impact, movement is actually kind of limited.
Oh shit! We got chains? Now this is music I can fight to.
Sounds like music I would skate to.
I love the detail of... What is that move that you do where you just, like, get electrocuted through your entire system?
I think that might be, like, a counter or something.
I just love the visual of, like, seeing the electricity coursing through your skeleton. That's such a cool detail.
Yeah.
Like, look at that! That's sick!
She's definitely some beach scar.
Oh shit, Frosty busting it out, dog.
Damn.
See, this is why we gotta listen to ska. We're gonna fight way better because of it.
I simply believe more fighting games should have ska.
That's why I'm working on Tough Breaker. I want Tough Breaker, my OC thing for anyone who doesn't know, to be the first shonen type thing you can listen to ska to. Or set ska to. Whether or not I'm... fulfilling that promise is up to you. But, like, if I ever make a fucking Tough Breaker fighting game, I'm gonna have the intro have Mighty Mighty Boss tones. You know, the Don't Knock on Wood guys?
Yeah.
Alright, good round. Oh, look at your hair spike.
Oh, there you have it. Alright, so we're doing this. Sets of three?
Yeah, but we're gonna... But, I think we'll just... For the sake of everyone being able to get an equal amount of play, let's not do a winner stays for this one.
That's fine by me.
I should also mention that there are unlockable characters, I think the bosses, but to do that, I'd have to play challenge mode, and, yeah, nah. I'm not doing that.
And there's no easy way to just get a full save?
Well, there is a full save file on GameFAQs, but it's for the Dex Drive, which is this obscure PS1 accessory where you can, like, connect to a computer to fuck around with your save files.
Oh.
Really an artifact of the old internet.
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely pro wrestler. Look at my look how thin my waist is.
He seems to speak pretty
high-pitched.
Yeah,
is there music in the background, or is it just really quiet?
It's just really quiet.
In the desert, there's no music.
Oh shit, what are we doing? Ah. No. Ooh, snapmare.
Techno workout music.
What are these noises that he's making?
His noises, man. You know. Oh fuck, oof! Man, I should have bought one of those move lists on my end.
Or do you only walk one step at a time in this game?
Yeah. That dash is pretty much the only way you move.
That's a joke.
It's weird.
I think Fire Impact may have been like that too, actually.
Oh shit, takedown!
Oh, what the fuck, why can't I follow it up? Oh well.
Yes!
You got it.
Oh man, did you see me twiddle my feet? That's to let you know we're about to go for the suplex. We're keeping it kayfabe, brother.
I hear some edgy lyrics in the background.
Yeah, is this industrial?
I bet.
Not really. More like nu metal.
Ah, ska and nu metal. Two flavors finally combining to one. Alright, that's two for each of us.
I guess we'll decide it.
Alright, let me go as Vikram, who is Kung Fu and Aikido.
I'm gonna stick to my guns and pick the non-alcoholic beer guy again. Where is he? There he is.
Okay.
Take this to the disco.
I was going to take you to campus, but all right. Let's boogie down. Let's boogie duty.
Let's boogie duty.
I'm never going to get this.
Ooh, that was cool. Oh, you know, there's actually some nice animations here with some of the grapples.
I agree, yeah.
Like, I imagine if we got two guys in there who knew the ins and outs of this game, it would look like fucking water. Like, it's almost kind of reminding me of Kensei, in a way. Which had some really nice animation itself. Kensei is by also, like, a really good Tekken clone, in my honest opinion, just saying.
System is it on?
PS1.
I never heard of it.
We play it every now and then. Me and Melly played it eons ago. I had a great time. It's a really good one. Tracks. All right, who wants going next? Just hit record. I guess we gotta see the sort of spokesgirl for this game because she was kind of everywhere in the advertising. Actually, here's a fun fact. She, Mia, and Oleg, who are in the same gang, appear in Slap Happy Rhythm Busters.
No kidding.
Yeah, same devs. Although Slap Happy is more of a Street Fighter type with this cool rhythm game look to it. Never played it, but I want to try it. Because it also has this janitor guy who's kind of got the Jotaro thing going on with his cap, so you know.
Oh, you're talking about Slap Happy Rhythm Busters, right?
Yep. So, you know, gotta represent my kind of guy.
All the character designs of that look so fucking sick.
I need to play that game. I have seen
it. Alright, let's take it to the stadium on campus, because we're playing the Tough Breaker game again. But for reals, I'm so glad I decided to make everyone college age now, because it really does open the door to so many ideas I can do.
Hold on a sec, I need to check out my moves.
Right, it's face buttons. You got a punch, you got a kick, you got a special attack, I think, and an evade block. That you can do. Blocking is actually hold back.
Okay.
Your punch and kick are your X and circles. Your evade is square with holding up and down. And triangle is that. I think that's X and circle together. It's all Tekken, so... Oh man, I'm schmoovin' on you. Whoa!
He's doing the fucking 10 string there for a second.
Yeah.
Like, so far, I'm not really hating this game. Like, it's got some weird quirks, especially with the movement and not being able to jump, but, like, this is fine. I'm vibing.
I don't like the very tight movement.
Yeah, that's definitely one of the bigger cons. Oh man, I almost kind of sort of did the Iron Mountain lean. Oh shit! Ah! Got me with the arm wrench. Come on, get moving. Oh shit. Oh, okay.
It sounds like this could be a real pop song.
That was kind of cool. I wish Mo could have been here for this, but Triple Mania is on tonight. That's Triple A's equivalent to WrestleMania. I wonder if they're still doing the Marvel Lucha thing.
Oh, right. The fucking, this freaking Spider-Man wrestler that they got.
It's kind of doing Sakura's dance right there. Yeah.
I still remember when you guys showed me the Marvel Lucha freaking Spider-Man and Venom wrestling match that they had. And that shit was so fucking cool.
Yeah, like I really hope they're still doing it because it was kind of lit. All right, let's see.
Oh yes, Oleg, the man who was half taxi cab.
All right, where do you want to take this? Go to the playground. Yeah, let's play on the swings. Me and my homies there.
Oh man, Lord BBH would fucking hate this loading screen. He hates
sliding puzzles.
Hates sliding puzzles in any game he's played. I mean, I hate him too.
Oh man, look at that! Look at that background though, gamer.
With this penis nose dude looking like Parappa the Rapper.
I see
that basketball on the ground. I'm wondering, does it have physics? Okay, that was that, I guess.
Oh, please. Somebody back. It's falling to see.
Oh, yeah, oh, it moves.
It does. Oh, my God, it does. That rocks.
I will say this is a very small court, though. Like it's quasi half court, but not really.
A weird relation, but now I'm just suddenly remembering this old demo for slam dunk typing. Anybody else remember that?
Slam dunk?
It's this freaking typing learning game where it's all basketball themed.
Was there like a purple hippopotamus character or something?
No. It was, hang on.
Because I might be thinking of something else. That's one for each of us.
Yep. I like this Oleg guy. I'm going to keep using him.
Let me go back to... Actually, let me go to the beach.
He's a taxi cab driver, don't you know?
He's part taxi cab.
All right, let's go to Miami. Party in the club and
name's a man. What's the name of that cartoon of that kid that transforms into a car?
Turbo Teen.
Yeah, this dude is like the modern age. It's a fucking cab driver.
God, imagine if, like, many years later, they were doing, like, a compilation of Taito characters for, like, some big crossover game, and, like, this guy, Raul, is who they pick to represent Versus. I mean, he looks the part, you know?
Oh, shit.
Interesting that this game has Dead or Alive style holds.
It's a little bit of everything.
Well, at least it doesn't have the exploding floor from the original DOA.
That would make this even funnier.
I'm pretty sure modern DOA sometimes adds that.
Modern DOA still has environmental hazard and stuff.
And stage transitions that do tons of damage.
Well, I mean, like, the first DOA where, like, one section of the arena is just the normal arena, but then everything else is just exploding arena, and it just does not look fun. Oh.
Okay. I don't know why you're saluting.
This guy's so weird.
Alright, let's see.
Alright, I'll be someone else for a change.
That's what Kara's about.
Alright. I'll meet you halfway.
Let's go to Chinatown.
Wonder what music you'll have for that.
Oh wow, Carl might be the worst character in the game because she barely has a move list.
Oh my god, yeah.
At least her costumes are different from itself.
Wait, which one am I?
I'm the flowy dress, you're the pants.
Okay. Oh man, the movement's really
bad. What
do
you really call a loincloth pants? I mean a dress.
I mean, you know, it's got flappies. It's fine enough.
Oh, she does not play well at all.
No.
She doesn't even play like the rest of the cast.
Like I said, like she's only got three moves. Apparently, two grapples and this thrusty thing.
You know what's strange?
She can't even block properly.
I think she's actually based off of Faraha from the original Fighters Impact. So I had blue skin.
Oh, you actually found something right there.
Yeah, and also a notable difference between these two characters is that Faraha constantly sidesteps as a boss. I might be very wrong about this asset reuse, but I don't know.
If anything, we could probably blame the people who wrote the manual. Unless Miles just found the best move. Yeah, they totally did. There we go.
There we go. All
Miles
right.
versus Robo.
Hate they had to click again to freaking move on there. That's stupid.
No, you gotta move left to right to change the gang. All right. Yes. Let's go to the rooftop at campus.
What options are there? Oh, nothing I want to fuck with.
Wow, they're actually trying to figure it out.
Fuck no, I'm just pressing buttons.
That's a strafe.
Oh my god, is this stage have ring outs? Please tell me there's ring
outs. Let's find out!
I know Fire's Impact had ring outs.
Oh fuck, let's find out. Let's see it, come on Oleg, take that dive!
Woo! Nope, not today.
Nope. Yep, there goes that arm wrench again.
How about you find out?
Fuck.
Ring
out.
I survived that.
No, I think we were just really lucky there.
No, you were you were literally corner trapping him and he didn't fall in. Also, how about this song, guys? Like hearing Siberia, Siberia.
I mean, that's not Siberia.
I gotta see it. I really do gotta find if there's like a band they hired for this game or something.
They probably hired a few.
This one versus manual. Cause like I remember actually finding the manual for fucking what was it? NHL Rock the Rink and finding that Canadian punk band, the Hanson Brothers. Get it? Because it's a hockey reference. Because they like hockey, guys. You know that?
It's funny because they're not the only band called the Hanson.
Oh, okay. There is ring outs.
Oh, okay. Here we go.
He just fucking killed her.
Well, that's what it's like on the Funaki campus. Okay, because that's a reference to my OC thing.
Oh, wait. No, I didn't want to do...
Let's see, PS1 manual archive.
This guy's so fucking stupid, I can't get over it. Where do you want to go, Robo?
Let's go to some vacant lot.
It's literally called vacant lot.
Let's see, versus... Let me at least find the OST. There's gotta be something. Someone's gotta have to have found everything. Okay, sweet. Okay, I found maybe, a set list.
Maybe this chick's more my speed.
Raised in Black, Los Infernos, The Suicide Machines, The Pigs in Space. Yeah, these sound like 90s bands. You know, everyone, name a made up 90s band in your head. Go for it.
Midnight Rocket Launcher.
Fat Dandies. Fat Grandpa and the No Goods.
The Severed Heads of Dread. Fucking Pink Lemonade.
Sausage Force.
It's even better because those two are names of actual bands in my own OC shits.
Oh, I mean, how about this one? How's Flat Soda sound?
Yeah, that sounds pretty apt.
I remember when you were talking about that on the Prod Crew server. How about Fiat Soda?
No, see, they're a cover band of Flat Soda, but they only perform in Italy. Their gimmick is they come out in the Lupin's yellow for Fiat.
Wait, was that somebody booing him? What the fuck?
No, I think that was just him making really stupid noises.
Ring.
Banana in Darkness. Actually, no, that's too modern. Apricot See, Cult.
Who haven't we seen yet? Well, other than the bosses.
Undeath
Dude, I think we saw him.
Let's see what Rommel Skies got.
Prescription for points.
Prescription for points. Zippers are us.
That's pretty good. Oh wow, you're already very close to finishing your guy.
How about this? Hard Body Junction.
Not bad.
All right. Oh my god. That's it. Oh wait. You got to switch those last two. You were almost there.
I actually did it.
And your reward is?
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
What do you mean? The ska is its own reward. Okay. He just like.
Well, you're like stomping jumpy boy shit.
Get off of me. Oh my god.
I don't need no martial arts. I just need to punch in
the face. Oh my god. You also have a fanny pack.
My man with a Hooters t-shirt just ground bouncing his friends all day.
No, he's okay, skanking. He's actually skanking.
What? I found my guy.
This is such fucking bullshit, dude.
Just because you're not skanking, Miles. What do you want me to tell you?
Why are you guys doing your fancy fighting shit? You just gotta punch people in the face.
This sucks.
I love this guy.
This is the most salty I've seen you.
Well, I have not been paying attention to who's been winning.
It's 2-1. I'm in the lead. I need to knock him down a peg for doing that.
For skanking all over you?
Yeah, for skanking all over me.
By the way, just so we're clear, skank is a real term. It's ska dancing.
That's funny.
Ska skank.
Yeah, go on and pick that guy again. Pick that guy again.
Like, that's basically what Robo was doing.
I don't know why. It's so weird with how his textures look. He looks like he's more. His skin to him just doesn't look right on his actual model.
Yeah, there's a bit of a hard yellow on his skin.
Alright, now this is the dream match right here. Ground Scout versus the taxi man.
Yeah, you're fighting outside of the Funaki student courtyard, the Red Star no, that's actually the science building, and the old field. Let the hate drive you to victory, Miles. Give in.
Why should you let him fucking do that?
This is payback! This is payback for all those. Oh, robot doesn't block! Who's blocking now?
That's literally the difference here.
Oh.
These guys DJ points.
I literally cannot block.
Oh, we're already doing a rematch?
Fucking right, I am.
Alright, that's 2-2.
your ass.
You what?
See, but there's an interesting dichotomy in the character designs right here. Like, again, I don't mean to talk about my... Well, actually, I did pick this game, so I do get to talk about my OCs more. Just joking, obviously, but... Like, the thing is, Oleg looks like he would actually fit in Tough Breaker, because he does have a little bit of flair with the weird taxi thing. But Ramos there, he's a jobber. He doesn't have too much going on in that design. Like, mate, you got baseball cap, you got an open vest, you're wearing two shirts, one short sleeve and one long sleeve, shorts, and some nasty-ass blue trainers. Mate, pick something. No. Oh, yeah, and you got a fanny pack.
I can say at the very least, you get rid of the fanny pack band, you're good. Believe me, it's somebody that wears a vest 90% of the time. See, Ramos would at least have a better fit if he was at least wearing some camo shorts, you know? That's how you look nice.
Yeah, I think camo goes great with fanny packs. I mean,
Frosty, Chris, hit X.
All right, fine.
There we go.
Good fight, by the way.
I don't know. Frosty versus Robo, just for Eric in the edit. I don't know. The camo, like, I don't know. I've never been a big fan of camo outside of military characters because it just feels right. I feel like if you're wearing camo in a casual setting, that's a bit kind of douchebaggy.
Hey, you take that back about Akira Kazama right now.
Fine, they get the pass.
Look, my fucking camo shorts, I didn't pick them entirely, but they're nice and comfy. And they have a lot of pockets.
And they're
honestly,
easy to
I need to buy more shorts for work. Someone hit start.
Oh, shit.
We're not actually going to solve this because it's not going to get us nothing.
Oh, shit. I keep forgetting I have to keep pressing the board. Fuck ass.
Alright. Oh shit, Frosty might win it.
Fuck.
This is a fighting Viper stage.
Yeah, it kind of is.
Yeah. This is just picky stage.
It really is.
You know, what if the fighting Vipers fought right next to the Mexico US wall? Oh, God help me, I'm so sorry. Oh god, no! I'm
no, they're fighting on the other side of the gamer wall, right there. You just can't see it.
I love the fact that, you know, because this stage only has so much detail. It looks like that this basketball court is like in the void.
Yeah. What, you never fight out in the void, in the hood void?
It's the basketball dimension. No! It's like when there's a Shaolin showdown, you know?
Yeah,
it's
and
like
a certain space is closed off.
To this. So it's just the ethereal basketball.
Oh, sweet.
Playing.
Jace got their internet back.
Hell yeah.
Fuck!
Oh, man. Can no one stop the skank?
This dude.
Yo, the basketball, hoop backing is not even round.
Remember, you gotta exit to change character.
I don't really
fuck. I that was my bad.
I don't really want to.
If you wanna change characters, just say.
I don't really wanna.
Okay, fair enough. We'll let it rock.
I'm gonna continue being the blind guy.
No, you're fucking, what's his name from Mortal Kombat?
That ain't Kenshi, bro.
Yeah,
that's
him.
Kenshi.
No, it's his cousin. Benshi from the Bronx. Alright, he's got the skanking going. He's gonna pick it up. That's my favorite thing in Ska, when they're like, pick it up. Oh, Frosty got one.
Hey.
See, do we want to change characters or
I think I'm good.
Okay.
We
all right, it's 1-1.
We continue to reside within the basketball dimension.
Yeah, where ninjas fight randoms in their fucking khaki shorts.
In the dunk zone.
Whoa, what is that? I want that to hit.
Nah, Frosty might have figured it out.
What is that move?
A shitty Goldberg tackle. That's what it is.
Oh, my spine.
You see, that's why he got the bump. Actually, no, that's why he's got the bum bag on, so he can take back bumps better. So that way he's got something to kind of break his fall.
Want to keep characters?
I want to see a few others just real quick.
All right, sure thing.
All right, so it's 2-1.
What is Rumble? I'm curious.
I think it might be a team mode.
That could be arcade.
That would track. Because there's a 1P versus, there's a 1P and a 2P mode of it.
Check it out after, when I get back in there. Because I want next.
I think more games should have team modes, honestly.
Like, yeah. The kind
of, you would see stuff like Tekken and Soul Calibur.
Yeah, just line them up and let's get going.
That actually reminds me of this old fucking, the first Yu Yu Hakusho Dark Tournament game on PS2, ugh, where they tried to, implement fucking tag team in that game.
No, it was bad. Even though it was not built. It would bring the game to a screeching halt.
Yeah, it would just freeze the game entirely.
Oh, like a Shang Tsung morph or something?
Exactly, yeah, almost. Like a Shang Tsung morph.
That's so funny.
All right, now let's talk about the dichotomy of Paco and the Ninja Guy's fits. I would actually say that the Ninja Guy would be trying too hard for the Tough Breaker verse. Like, yeah, ninjas exist, but like, you know, you're supposed to be stealthy. You're supposed to blend in. You shouldn't just be wearing the old robes out in the day. Paco's got it smart. This guy's own little flair, like maybe khaki pants.
Well, oh my God.
Okay. Just punched him off.
I think you've managed to figure out a stage pick.
Like, if Paco added a little something extra to his big shirt, he might be like not a major friend to Tiago in the group. He might just.
Maybe I need to start experimenting a bit more.
I love that fucking push. Just like, oh,
right. Two to two.
Regular idol pose for his victory pose.
2-2.
He would definitely be an informant character for Tiago. Like, he wouldn't be in the main crew, but he'd be something like, you know, if we see his young in the hall, it's like, hey, Paco, hey, Tiago, what's going on? You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like, he's not cool enough to be in the regular rotating cast. Right.
All right. That's a smart choice. Tiago, Paco. Oh, God, I don't even know any of these other characters.
Wait, have we seen Thana yet?
I'm not sure.
She's apparently a shrimper.
I think. Does that mean that she fishes for shrimp?
Yes.
Sure. Let's find out. Let's see what they're about.
That's what a shrimper is, just like a lobster.
Wait, we gotta go to the disco. Have we been to the disco yet?
I don't think so.
Yeah, let's hit the discotheque.
I think that's a stage from the demo.
Oh yeah, we did play us on that demo disc that I totally meant to put out before my computer crapped on me. Yeah, I didn't forget, it's just, you know, I had to hustle after getting everything back.
Fighting game player, that beast of versus sliding puzzle before the match starts every time.
Fuck this.
God damn it. I was getting into it.
I was closer to it than you.
Holy looks like Robo found his move again.
Like this? Oh no!
How do you keep finding characters like this?
Well, guys, oh my God, Frosty, is your dude a stance fighter? He's kind of got the Jun Hoon shit going.
Yeah, I really
fuck
do.
Your stances. We just punch people.
All right, then I just kick people then. Or not?
I'm here for your Tekken 3 Howlrong kick spam.
You know, Robo, seeing how you play Marisa, this does not surprise me at all.
Come on, Frosty, hit him with that baked Dosan shit.
I say as someone who also mains Marisa in Street Fighter 6.
There we go.
I haven't played Street Fighter 6 in a hot minute, though.
All right, to bring in the character designs, Paco would definitely be a character from a rival college. He'd come from Heyman University. He's down from Jersey.
I managed to win the set.
All right, I'll come back in.
Sure thing. A rematch for him with you.
Taking hands? Yeah, that's us right now.
Okay, let's see. What is Rumble? Just choose whoever.
That sounds fine to me. I figure I had to aim high after seeing what Robot's been doing to everybody.
All right,
you at aiming high? Believe me, my aiming high has been totally accidental.
All right, what
Slim Daddy got?
All right, my favorite stage, the parking lot. That's also my least favorite stage because you can't call the cops if you're in a car accident. And now I'm just realizing that I'm
going up against this pimp with kung fu shit.
No,
like
I'm
a fucking Black Dynamite character up in here.
Realizing that I have an extremely good low jab. What else do I got?
Damn it.
Also, we were talking about Virtuoso, right?
Yeah.
I decided to look up what the artist for that game was.
Tie-Dye Suicide.
Tie-Dye. And it's not just like Thai, like tie-dye.
It's like Thai as in the country Thailand.
Thailand.
Stupid shit you can only get away from the 90s.
No. Yeah. Yeah.
You could really... It's You really could just win by mashing in this game.
Is your guy okay there? He's having an episode.
I suppose he is. Yeah, he's pretty fun.
Oh, okay, so that's what Rumble is. You pick a gang and you gotta play them out. Okay. I like that. I guess that'll be the set.
Well, actually, I have... Fair enough.
Maybe we should not have chosen the same gang.
Oleg Mirror.
No, actually, I'm able to play the guys you still have. You don't have. I guess the traits... I guess I'm the...
Loser leaves one of their guys.
Pretty much. And also, furthermore, if they pick the same gang, it's treated like a separate gang.
Very interesting concept, honestly.
Snap suplex!
Now, this is also probably just me and some of the other stuff that I've played, but the feel of this also kind of reminds me of,
Achilles Hold!
Fighter Maker on PS1.
Yeah, a bit.
I can see it.
Alright, got the pro wrestling going.
Still remember messing around with that, trying to understand how it worked. I actually more messed around with, the PS2, Fighter Maker 2 a little bit more, and...
God, that thing ate up that thing would eat up your memory card hard.
Oh, to hell and back. I actually do have some save files that I think I'm going to try porting those over onto this computer since they were on the PS3. And I made a bunch of my characters. I made Mally, I made Java, I made Aval, I think I made Playa.
No.
I just picked a bunch of moves that I thought fit them, and it's very rough. And for their bios, I kind of just chose a bunch of... I just filled up as best I could, because this was still very early on in how the lore that I had established for them.
You know, I gotta...
It's not like now...
Sorry, go ahead. Papers. No, you go ahead. Finish your story.
Well, it's not like how I have now, where I think everybody knows at least the basics of my lore that I have thus far.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. A lot of that is just... not that present in my earlier shits, but that's also just because, you know...
You're starting out.
Fine-tuning, it's the first draft. Very first draft. But, you were saying?
I have an interesting story about Fighter Maker 2. I bought it in the summer of 2007. And I remember being kind of overwhelmed with it. It was a Monday night. Just got on for a game, so I popped in and like, this is cool, but I don't know. This definitely wasn't what I was expecting. Let's turn on Raw and see what's happening.
Wow,
Chris Benoit is no longer with us. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. That's the week I decided to play that game.
Jeez.
Unfortunate. So whenever I think of Fighter Maker 2, I think of that. Hey, let's talk about something fun, huh?
Oh,
let's actually bring back to the game. I did make one character. I made, for some reason at this time, Cool Anime Bart with a bunch of presets.
I made Playa, but like she had this backhand move that I gave a massive hitbox. So whenever anybody would even come close to that move, and I should note that you just did like a basic button input for that move, she would just backhand them and it sent everybody flying because I set it to have knockback. So just imagine Playa doing a fucking, like that, you know that cool pack of the head kind of thing.
Yeah.
Just imagine that, but like from a distance, and then just fucking sending them careening back.
Oh god. Oh shit. Wow, it actually reacted to my body hitting the ground. I did not expect that level of detail.
His spine is broken.
Oh, more than his spine, dog. His everything is done messed up.
He's dead.
I mean, if you want to strong arm it like that, sure.
So, you're a Reeve Drave DJ, and I'm a club kid.
Oh, sorry. Let's go back to the lot.
Yes.
Oh. She recalled there was one other fighting game maker that I messed around with, and actually it was with Frosty. It was the 2D one.
Kakugiyaro.
Yeah, Kakugiyaro. I screwed around with that with Frosty one night, and we made just basic representations of a fair few of our characters. I made Aval, Playa, and I think I tried making Java. We made one that's a kind of would just be a palette swap kind of character of one of ours. Who was it? It was a Landlubber character, right, Frosty?
Was it Migochi? Yeah, it was a Landlubber character.
I think so.
I think we made one more character, but I can't remember who. It might have been Crimino. But I don't know, it just... I don't know why, but I kind of felt like... Oh, God.
Somehow I figured that out.
Very good.
So now I would love to actually learn how to make shit with Mugen at some point. My approach would be something along the lines of like how a character would be animated in Street Fighter Alpha. Some pretty good keyframes, not super in-depth detail to a lot of the animations, but you know, just enough. That just looks nice.
Oh, right, duh. Oh god.
Oh, we got ring out.
Oh.
The stage reminds me of Vicious Circle because there's a stage that's just like this.
Oh jeez, Vicious Circle. Actually, I'm more reminded of something from Fighting Lair.
I think I know which stage you're talking about.
That, the Construction Yard stage, that's in Virtua Fighter 3 as well.
I guess construction stages are just very popular in fighting games.
Admittedly, when it comes to the Virtual Fighter 3 stage, I think, oh hey, it's the Radical Highway stage.
God.
Oh goodness gracious.
Yes, come on, get that ring out. Come on, Mia, I know you got it, baby.
Come on, Oleg. Get her out. Go for the crazy bonus.
Stop sidestepping.
No way, die.
Man, I just hit you with a crazy jump.
Well, the game's Eric.
Yeah. Oh, GG's. Whoa, what was that creepy glow at the end? Whoa.
Jesus Christ.
All right. Weird. Well, I think that's more than enough. Want to call it here, y'all?
Yeah, I think we've pretty much gotten everything out of this.
Ugh, man, versus.
Let the thumbnail just be Oleg's face.
Yeah, please, definitely. Please. It's definitely going to be that. But if there's anything we can take from this game, it's that more fighting games need ska.
I agree.